Well, to understand better our approach, it is worth mentioning that we count with an exclusive production technology for the nanoparticles, which is extremely versatile regarding the compositions that can be obtained. And this is very important for the multi-metallic nanomaterials that are required in the project, specifically in the World Package 3. Well, the technology that I mentioned, it is called flame spray pyrolysis, FSP. And another important feature for this technology is its scalability. This is also relevant for a future production at pilot or at industrial scale. Concerning more this initial stage of the project, we have been focused on the synthesis of bimetallic oxides based on molybdenum. In fact, we have produced various batches of these materials, and we have selected a couple of them for additional characterization. These complex nanomaterials will be used combined with other structures, like, for example, hierarchical zeolites. For the combination of these two materials, the procedure will be impregnation. That's why another important activity for us in the project is the preparation of suitable nanodispersions. To achieve a good separation and a good distribution of the nanoparticles in powder form, once we have it inside the liquid to prepare this dispersion, it is very important, this distribution and this separation, to achieve a good deposition on the different substrate structures, and also to have finally a good catalytic effect from these nanomaterials. That's one of the key aspects of this project. To carry out all these activities, we have been collaborating with different partners, mainly with the company Tecnan. This company comes with equipment for the industrial production of nanomaterials, and somehow this ensures a future supply for these sophisticated materials. Apart from the company Tecnan, we have been also collaborating with Democritus for this additional characterization. Regarding some of the selected samples, they are carrying out some specific testing regarding the physicochemical properties of the nanoparticles to know more about these nanomaterials and to maximize its effect. And additionally, we are collaborating with the CNRS, which includes University of Lille and Poitiers. And with them, the collaboration is regarding the definition of the best dopants for the bimetallic species that we are producing. The information that they are compiling from the modeling is a useful feedback for us, and also is important because it connects the experimental results and the simulation results, and that enables a better control for the process and the future properties of these materials.